Today, I'm pushing some old laptops to the limits with my custom water cooler. In my last video, I repurposed the Pentium PC's water cooling system into a powerful external water cooler, and I'm finally going to do something with it. I was planning on making this a permanent setup for my gaming laptop, the Legion, but haven't found a good way of doing this while keeping it portable and without permanently modifying it to an extent. In the meantime, let's see what this cooler can do. First up is an old Asus laptop I've been using as a security camera server. With a broken screen, it's perfect as a little desktop, or server in my case. I gave it a quick dusting and put the cover back on to direct airflow. I then ran Cinebench R23 with hardware monitor to track temps and wattage. This gives us our baseline before we start modifying anything. I also placed a thermometer probe on the exhaust air vent to measure the exhaust air temperature. With the stock cooling system, the CPU scored 3380 points. It spiked to 100 degrees Celsius, throttled back to around 15 watts, and then settled around 70 degrees Celsius. Exhaust air peaked at 38.3 degrees. Clearly, the stock system can't handle a full load. To see how much difference airflow alone makes, I removed the cover and aimed a large extractor fan directly at the motherboard and heatsink, with a thermometer probe on the heat pipe. During the stress test, temperatures rose to around 75 degrees, with the heatsink at 64. The wattage climbed to 20 watts and the score jumped to 4579 points, which is an 18% gain over stock. Running the same test with no airflow at all, quickly pushed the CPU to an internal temperature of 90 degrees and a heatsink temperature of 79 degrees, followed by the laptop shutting itself down for safety. Airflow clearly matters. Let's find out how hard I can push the CPU. I started by disconnecting the battery and power cable to protect the laptop while I work on it. I unscrewed the heatsink and removed it. The stock thermal compound has become very dry and crusty, so changing the paste with new one would already help the cooling system a lot. I managed to scrape most of the old paste off and could then admire the shiny CPU dye. I then stuck some electrical tape on the cold plate of the CPU water block, so it couldn't short out on the small surface mounted components next to the CPU. I gooped some thermal paste on both dies and then spread them out with a piece of plastic. After which I could carefully place the water block on top of the dies and weigh it down for good contact. When plugging the AC power back in, the laptop turned back on and I could start the benchmarks. After also turning on the water cooler, the CPU was able to continuously draw 30 watts. It reached 70 degrees and steadily held that for the entire run. The water temperature started at around 33 degrees and went up to 38. The Cinebench score averaged 5,661 points, which is 46% more than the stock cooling system and 24% more than the fan cooled runs. Curious of what the water temperature would be if not being cooled by the radiator, I disabled the two fans and ran another benchmark. The water temperature started at 34 degrees and peaked on 42.9 degrees, which is pretty warm but didn't impact the performance, as the CPU still got 5,581 points, which is within margin of error for my testing. I could then disconnect the laptop's power again and remove the water block. I spread the thermal paste back out and reattached the stock heatsink. I did some more stock cool tests with the new thermal paste and found that it didn't meaningfully affect the score or temperatures. This most likely means that the stock heatsink and fans are the bottleneck, not the thermal paste. I also tested my portable laptop, the Microsoft Surface 3. This one has an Intel Core i5-1035G7, which is one generation lower than the chip in the Asus laptop from before. I did a test with the laptop's stock cooling system, where the CPU stayed around 70 degrees after thermal throttling. The metal cover got up to 44 degrees Celsius and it managed to get a score of 2021 points. With the water block pressed onto the back with some thermal paste, the CPU temp stayed around 70 degrees, but the cover temperature went down to around 40. The Cinebench score went up a little, to around 2341 points. This laptop managed to warm the water by around 1 degree. And that's about it. Who knew hooking up a big water cooler to your laptop's cramped cooling system would increase your performance? All jokes aside, I'm still hoping to get this cooler attached to my gaming laptop eventually. If you have any ideas for making this a viable solution, please let me know in the comments. I also just started my final year of high school and won't have as much time for making content as I'd like. That means I probably won't stick to a fixed upload schedule, not that I really did anyways. But that just makes subscribing even more worth it, since you'll be notified the moment a new video drops. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.